video series covers all the work and projects we've been doing around my mom's house in Virginia. She's got an acre of property here, and there's lots of repairs and maintenance that needs to be done on the house. And then out here, just general brush and yard cleanup. A bunch of junk is piled up everywhere. The whole back area here behind the shed is full of junk from years and me just dumping things. Things I intended to eventually use, but probably for the most part never really did. Most of that's already been cleaned up and burned here. Now we're just getting down to the brush and the last of it. Like there's some chain link fence that I'm trying to dig out eventually. All the kind of brown looking areas there has all been sprayed with weed killer, which makes it a whole lot easier to get the weeds up, clumps. You just rake it in a pile and it pulls up real easy. There's all kinds of wood and just trash all buried in there as well that I've been raking up as I go and burning or hauling to the dump, of course. This series is dedicated to my mom, and I'm just trying to pay her back for all the things she did for me over the years, all the things she sacrificed. And I've been a real screw up at times, and she was always there for me, and I thank her so much. And hopefully this series, you can learn something as well from, or teach me a thing or two. I'd love to hear from you. Leave a comment below with your experiences if you've done similar kind of stuff. As you can see, I still got a bunch of junk behind the shed here that is pretty much overflow stuff that didn't quite fit in the shed. I'll tell you one thing, maintaining an acre of land and rural property is a lot more work than people think. And it's just paying back Mom a little bit for all the things she's done for me, all the things she's sacrificed and gave me over all these years. It's the least I can do. This old yard sweeper has been back here and was basically buried in the brush for probably close to 10 years. The vinyl part is all tore up and ripped, but I was able to put it back together, lubricate it, get it broke loose to where the wheels were spinning again and the brushes were spinning, and it ended up working pretty good. I cover all that in another part of the series, so if you're interested, make sure and check it out. I didn't think the thing would still work, or it was so far gone. But you gotta tune in for the next video to see how I fixed it up and what the results were. Oh, great. No line. clearing brush around this old chain link fence. The weeds and grass, vines and everything grew up all through it, so kind of a pain to get it loose. We had previously sprayed the whole area with weed killer though, so that's why it's all brown. Made it a whole lot easier.